Good morning, friends. Today we are going to discuss about special economic zone. Today in this lecture we will be discussing about what is a special economic zone, a brief review, history of free trade zone or special economic zone, objective and rules of special economic zone, activity in SEZ, administrative setup of special economic zone, facilities offered to special economic zones and SEZs in India. So we should start with the what is special economic zone. A special economic zone is a geographical region that has economic laws different from a country's typical economic laws. A special economic zone is a specifically delineated duty-free enclave and shall be deemed to be foreign territory for the purpose of trade operations and duties and tariffs. In other words, SEZ is a geographical region that has economic laws different from a country's typical economic laws. Usually, the goal is to increase foreign investments. SEZ have been established in several countries including China, India, Jordan, Poland, Kazakhstan, Philippines and Russia. North Korea has also attempted this to a degree. So, we should have a brief review of special economic zones. Special economic zone, it covers a broad range of more specific zones including free trade zone, FTZ, export processing zone, EPZ, free zones, FZ, industrial states, free ports, urban enterprise zones and others. Now we will discuss one by one of all these factors. Free trade zones. A specific class of specific zone, economic zone, it is a geographic area where goods may be landed, stored, handled, manufactured, or reconfigured and re-exported under specific customs, regulation and generally not subject to custom duties. Export processing zones are an area set up to enhance commercial and industrial exports by encouraging economic growth through investment from foreign entities. Incentives such as tax exemptions and a barrier-free environment are the main attraction of an EPZ. Free zones are also known as free economic zones, FEZ, free economic territories, FETs, or free zones, FZ. These are a class of specific economic zones designated by the Trade and Commerce Administrations of various countries. The term is used to designate area in which companies are taxed very lightly or not at all to encourage economic activity. Means they have very low rate of taxes. Industrial states, these are also known as industrial park or industrial trading states. It is an area zoned and planned for the purpose of industrial development. An industrial park can be thought of as a more heavyweight version of business park or office park, which has offices and light industry rather than heavy industry. Friends, you might have seen in all districts of your state where at the outskirts of the districts, there is always an industrial area. Now coming on free ports. Free ports or zones are designated by the government as area with little to no tax in order to encourage economic activity. An early type of special economic zones was free ports. These historically were endowed with favorable customs regulations. Now, urban enterprise zones and others. Urban enterprise zones policies generally offer tax concessions, infrastructure incentives, and reduced regulations to attract investment and private companies into the zones. They are a type of special economic zone where companies can locate free of certain local, state and federal taxes and restrictions. History of free trade zones. The first was in Shannon Airport in Clare, Ireland. We know free zones and entry ports have been used for countries to guarantee free storage and exchange along trade routes. Modern SEZ appeared from the late 1950s in industrial countries. From the 1970s onwards, zones providing labor intensive manufacturing have been established starting in Latin America and East Asia. The first in China following the opening in China in 1979 by Deng Xiaoping was the Shenzhen Special Economic Zone, which encouraged foreign investment and simultaneously accelerated industrialization in this region. These zones attracted investment from multinational corporations. A recent trend has been for African countries to set up special economic zones in partnership with China. India was one of the first in Asia to recognize the effectiveness of the export processing zone model in promoting exports, with Asia's first EPZ set up in Kandla in 1965. With a view to overcome the shortcomings experienced on account of the multiplicity of controls and clearance, absence of world-class infrastructure and an unstable fiscal regime, with a view to attract larger foreign investment in India, the Special Economic Zones policy was announced in April 2000. This policy intended to make SEZs an engine for economic growth, supported by quality infrastructure, complemented by an attractive fiscal package both at the center and the state level. With the minimum possible regulations, SEZ in India functioned from 1st November 2000 to 9 February 2006 under the provisions of the foreign trade policy, and fiscal incentives were made effective through the provisions of relevant status. To instill confidence in investors and signal the government's commitment to a stable special economic zone policy regime, and with a view to impart stability to the special economic zone regime, thereby generating greater economic activity and employment through the establishment of SEZ, a comprehensive draft SEZ bill prepared after extensive discussions with the stakeholders. A number of meetings were held in various parts of the country, both by Prime Minister and for the Minister of Commerce and Industry, as well as senior officials of this purpose. The Special Economic Zone Act 2005 was passed by Parliament in May 2005, which received presidential assent on the 23rd of June 2005. The draft SEZ rule were widely discussed and put on the website of the Department of Commerce, offering suggestions comments. Around 800 suggestions were received on the draft rules. After extensive consultation, the SEZ Act 2005, supported by the SEZ rules, came into effect on 10th February 2006, providing for drastic simplification of procedures and for single window clearance on matters relating to central as well as state government. Now, the main objective of the SEZ. These are generation of additional economic activity, promotion of exports of goods and services, promotion of investment from domestic and foreign sources, creation of employment opportunities, development of infrastructure facilities. It is expected that this will trigger a large flow of foreign and domestic investment in special economic zones in infrastructure and productive capacity, leading to generation of additional economic activity and creation of employment opportunities. The SEZ Act 2005 2005 envisages key role for the state governments in export promotion and creation of related infrastructure. A single window SEZ approval mechanism has been provided through a 19-member interministerial SEZ board of approval, which is known as BOA. The applications duly recommended by the respective state governments or union territories administrations are considered by this board of approval periodically. All decisions of the board of approvals are with the consensus. The SEZ rules provide for different minimum land requirement for different class of SEZs. Every SEZ is divided into a processing area where alone the SEZ units would come up and the non-processing area where the supporting infrastructure is to be created. The SEZ rules, these are the rules, simplified procedure for development, operation and maintenance of the special economic zones, for setting up units and conducting business in special economic zones. Single window clearance for setting up an special economic zone, single window clearance for setting up a unit in a special economic zone, single window clearance on matters relating to central as well as state governments, and simplified compliance procedures and documentation with an emphasis on self-certification. Now, what are the activities which takes place in the special economic zones? Manufacturing, trading related activities of SEZ include manufacturer and trade of apparels, garment and leather, automobile and auto components, engineering, light, heavy and application, pharmaceutical, food processing, telecom equipment, computer hardware and microelectronics, consumer electronics, appliances, gems, jewelry and diamonds, woods, rubber, plastic and leather products and handicrafts. These activities are can take place in the special economic zones and the import or export can be done. Types of SEZ. This is the very important slide. Special economic zones are classified into four specialized zones. Please remember this with care. Free trading and warehousing zones facilitate import of goods and services freely to carry out trade transactions in free currency. This is known as the free trading zone. A special economic zone for multi-product is the zone where the units are set up for manufacturing or trading and warehousing or rendering of two or more goods in a sector. A special economic zone for a specific sector is meant exclusively for one or more products or services in a particular sector. A special economic zone in a port or airport means a special economic zone in an existing port or airport for a special economic zone. Now coming on the administrative setup. Structurally, SEZ has three-tier administrative setup. The central apex body is called the Board of Approval and is headed by the Secretary Department of Commerce, which I have told you in the previous slide. The approval committee is further divided into different zones headed by a development commissioner who should be an ex-officio chairperson of the approval committee. Units are set up in the SEZ once it gets an approval from the Board of Approval and the area for establishing SEZ has been defined. The zonal approval committee consists of development commissioner, customs authorities and respective representatives of state government or union territories administration. Incentives and facilities offered to the SEZ. The units in SEZ are given many incentives and facilities to attract domestic as well as foreign investment, which can be summed up as following. Goods are imported without levying any duty and domestic procurement of goods for development, operation and maintenance of SEZ units. 100% income tax exemptions on export income for SEZ units under section 10AA of the Income Tax Act for first 5 years, 50% for next 5 years, thereafter 50% of the plugged back export profit for next 5 years. Exemption from minimum alternate tax under section 115 JB of the Income Tax Act. External commercial borrowing by SEZ units up to $500 million in a year without any maturity restriction through recognized banking channels. Exemption from GST. Single window clearance for central and state level approvals. Exemption from the other levies as extended by the representative state governments. Where are SEZ located in India? At present, there are 8 functional SEZs located at Santapur, Maharashtra, Cochin, Kerala, Kandla, Surat, Gujarat, Chennai, Tamil Nadu, Visakhapatnam, Andhra Pradesh, Palta, West Bengal, Noida, Uttar Pradesh, India. Further, an SEZ in Indore, Madhya Pradesh is now ready for operation. In addition, 18 approvals have been given for setting up of SEZs at Pochitra, Gujarat, Navi Mumbai and Kopata, Maharashtra, Nanguneri, Tamil Nadu, Kalpi and Salt Lake, West Bengal, Paradeep and Gopalpur, Odisha, Bhadohi, Kanpur, Muradabad and Greater Noida in Uttar Pradesh, Visakhapatnam and Kakinada in Andhra Pradesh, Valar, Padam or Puttu, Yapin in Kerala, Harshan, Karnataka, Jaipur and Jodhpur, Rajasthan on the basis of proposal received from the state governments. On this, one special economic zone denotified between April 2008 and February 2020. 101 cases of denotification between these two periods has been done, as you are seeing in this slide. The Board of Approval on Special Economic Zones has approved 101 class cases of denotification between April 1, 2008 and February 29 this year. Parliament was informed on Friday, March 20, 2020. These denotification approvals are subject to the refund of all duties and taxes benefits availed by the SEZ private developers and unreceived of no objection from the concerned state government. This was the all the matter in this chapter. In the next chapter, we will discuss about the export processing zone. In this chapter, we will discuss what is the export processing zone, objective of setting up of export processing zone, advantage of and disadvantage of export processing zone, management of export processing zone, three-tier system and export processing zone in India. So, thank you very much for all this. Hope to meet you again in the next video.